Italy is the land of dolce vita, sumptuous food and wine, and its cooking has some of the most vibrant and exciting flavors in the world. But why? What makes here so unique? Ciao, I'm Lawrence Lowe. Let me bring you to Umbria, the green heart of Italy. It is the only region in Italy that does not border the sea. But in this landlocked area in central Italy, I discovered a true gourmet paradise. So what are the sights and sounds?
But come here, let me show you something really, really special. I love this place. Look at this, I'm in a gourmet food shop, and as soon as I come in, a beautiful lake of prosciutto. This is Italy. And look at this, puff, a wall full of pasta. And as we're in Umbria, we have this specialty pasta called strangozzi. And obviously in Italy, we have pasta, spaghetti, but this is spaghettoni, long, really long spaghetti. And then come, this is heaven for me. Look at the sausages in the counter. All different kinds of cheese. With cheese with black truffles, pecorino. Look at this. This is the head of a wild boar, cingale, which is a specialty here in Umbria because we're in the heartland, green heartland of Italy, full of wild animals. This is heaven for me.
Umbria is proud of its agriculture and has arguably the most important wine and olive museums in Western Europe, where one can discover and learn about viticulture and olive oil making.
This one, you can smell the spiciness, the nuttiness, and the grassiness. Now, we always want to taste the olive oil. Now, a lot of Chinese, we think, oh my god, I'm drinking raw oil. It's disgusting. Am I going to have diarrhea? 拉肚子? No way, because remember, olive oil is a medicine. Good uncut grass, spice, nutty. Delayed reaction, spice, spicy, just like Sichuan peppercorn, but in the back of the throat. That means that your olive oil is healthy, full of polyphenol and full of antioxidants.
Coffee, to many people, is just a hot drink. But in Italy, it is a part of life and a form of art.
Italian coffee culture. What are the different cafes, coffees you can have? The first one you have is this. It's the espresso. It's the foundation of all coffee. You must have the crema on top, which shows the quality of the coffee. The second one is this, cafe macchiato. So you have espresso with hot milk. The third one we have is cafe americano. So, which is kind of a dark coffee. And then you have the cappuccino, which is espresso with hot milk. And then you can draw different kind of patterns on top. Another one is called the Dominicano or cafe crema. So you have espresso with cream. And what I can also do is put a little bit of chocolate powder on top as well. And the last but not least, this is great for the winter weather, hot, pure decadence of Italian hot chocolate. Look at that, thick, thick hot chocolate, beautiful for winter.
Now, let's taste the sweet Pasito red wine from indigenous grapes.
Look at this grape. Look at this grape here. This is all shriveled up. So basically what this is that they would harvest this in October, then they would put it on a straw mat, put it in a hut to let it air dry until about January. And the result is this. You have this shriveled up grape, which is full of sugar. Salute!
I'm also very lucky to get a masterclass from a famous local chef.
It's lovely. With these green fava beans, after my restaurant, we will cook for you one spectacular recipe of 1800. The name of this pasta is a frascarello.
Frascarello.
Well done, Lorenzo.
Shake, 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 shake. Put 2 handfuls of beans, pecorino cheese.
Last but not least, Umbria countryside is a fantastic place to relax and far niente.
3 liter bottle of red wine poured into this bathtub, and of course they give you a glass of Rubesco red wine. And
How else can you better enjoy life than a sip of wine and salute?